Blessed be the eternal fire. In its radiance,
Geralt the Rivian.
Cade Mill.
Huh.
You want to guard the camp like it's the Emperor's treasure?
Yes, Your Excellency.
Special.
Let so much as a flea slip.
Welcome.
Cade Mill.
Look who's here, the Rivian Witcher.
Greetings.
Our paths cross often, it seems.
Too often.
What do you seek here?
Triss Merigold.
In the Nilfgaardian camp? Fistek has addled your brain.
Lower your sword, son.
You've got cheek, Geralt.
Let's go. One false move and your ambassador will never see Nilfgaard's son again.
My men won't let you leave here alive.
They will if you ask them to, Excellency, and I believe you will.
Reynold Ep Madsen's orders come from the Emperor himself. He'd rather die than give you Merigold.
Then he'll die. Out of the way, all of you, or the old man dies.
Hold there!
I'm not joking.
I know. And I advise you not to hesitate. Kill him. For we shan't move one bit.
Renwald!
He who brings me the Witcher's head will get the Order of Merit.
But Ambassador FitzEsterlin?
Your Excellency. Orders from the capital.
Now I'll have to kill you all.
What are you waiting for? Get him!
Long live the Emperor! Did you really think you could just prance in here? Make the Emperor proud! Kill him! Army's ranks are endless! Congratulations, Witcher. They were my best men.
Free Triss, or join them.
You amaze me. How can you risk your life for a witch?
There are things you and your kind will never comprehend.
And what are those?
Friendship.
Tell me, is the friendship of traitors and conspirators worth it?
Talking about?
Your friend and the other witches conspired against your rulers.
How do you know that?
From the best possible source. She confessed.
And how did you convince her to do that?
By showing her the confessions of other Lodge members.
I don't believe you.
That's irrelevant at this point. During our chat, my people managed to regroup, call for reinforcements.
Maybe now they'll start fighting like men.
Time to show you the Empire's true power. Surround him! Long live the Emperor!
Shield bearers, forward!
Are you kidding? The only person you expect to see in a Nilfgaardian dungeon is the executioner.
Did they torture you?
They tried various things, but they got nothing from me.
When I left Flotsam with Vernon, I somehow doubted I'd find you so soon.
I know it was hard on you. I'll never forget this, you hear? Never.
Couldn't you ask your friends from the Lodge for help? Just do. Listen, Triss, to come here for you, I had to split up with Vernon. Temeria is in danger of disintegrating.
Are you sorry you chose to come here?
No, I'm not. But freeing you from Shillard's grasp was not my only reason for coming here. I need you to explain your role in this mess. And to explain why you lied to me.
That's not true.
I know about the Lodge. I know the Lodge was behind Demoven's assassination. I know Triss Marigold is a member of the Lodge.
It's not like that.
Show me the error in my reasoning.
True. I'm a member of the Lodge. Just like 8 other sorceresses. But if you think I'm responsible for the Lodge's actions, you're badly mistaken. The Lodge is a theater for 2 actresses. Sheila and Philippa have long dominated it.
To the point where you didn't know about the murder they planned?
To the point where I was no longer invited to gatherings.
Why?
They stopped trusting me.
Because you didn't agree with them?
9 women very rarely agree on anything. The actual problem was that...
Tell me.
I was close to you. If Sheila fears anyone, it's Geralt of Rivia. The Lodge did everything to convince me that our relationship didn't bother them, even that it suited them. But they manipulated me. Through me, they fed you select information. Depending on the circumstances, they twisted facts.
We're still close. They could still be doing it.
Don't insult me.
Calm down, Triss. Reynold Epp Matson claimed otherwise, but I'll always take your word over that of some Nilfgaardian lowlifes. Now, you'll tell me everything you know. I need to learn the truth.
All existing councils of mages disintegrated after the Thanet massacre. We all acted separately. Philippa decided to create a new organization, a secret one this time. When I was sworn in, it never crossed my mind that the Lodge's plans would soon become secret to its members. As you know, Philip was not one for minor undertakings. She presented a plan for creating a powerful state controlled by sorceresses.
No wonder the kings are opposing the sorceresses. Nobody likes a schemer.
Philippa and Sheila never lacked ideas or enthusiasm. To control a powerful state, they needed to create one first. Or find a wealthy land with a suitable political arrangement and an easily manipulated ruler. Sheila chose the Pontar Valley, Demavend, and Stennis.
Demavend hated mages.
No more than Henselt or Radovid. Sheila and Philippa saw Demavend as the weakest ruler. His son, Stennis, blows hot and cold. Plus, he who controls the Pontar Valley controls the North. So it was in Edirne that a popular rebel emerged, preaching the idea of a new state. At one of our meetings, I just asked how they imagined overthrowing Demavend. That was the last time I was invited. After Demavend's death, I became suspicious but had no evidence. Philippa brushed me off. When you went off to meet Yorveth and Sheila was busy with the Cairn's carcass, I managed to scan parts of her megascope. That's when I learned that Sheila had dealings with Letho.
If only I'd learned that, everything could have been different.
Letho must have shadowed me when I entered Sheila's room. Then he forced me to teleport us to somewhere near Vergen.
Did you talk to him?
He wasn't aggressive. In Vergen, he told me that Sheila commissioned them to assassinate Demavend. Them being the witchers of the School of the Viper. Sheila helped them prepare the assassination.
I wonder why he told you about it.
Is that important?
Conspirators who suddenly divulge everything? I'd be suspicious.
There was some interference as we teleported to Edirne. I emerged intact, but pretty battered. I knew Philippa was in the area. I decided to go see her and lay my cards on the table.
Maybe Letho wanted just that.
I met a woman at Philippa's house. Thought she was just a servant or Philippa's lover. Before I could speak, I was overpowered by spells. I hardly expected an attack. The pain I felt as my body was compressed. It's indescribable. As if all my bones were being broken. It's even worse when you return to your true form. In any case, Philippa had no idea her lover was a Nilfgaardian spy. I was carried as that figurine all the way to Loch Bleen. Asira decompressed me back just before they murdered her. Shillard interrogated me, but learned nothing. If it wasn't for you, they'd have had me quartered. I didn't piece the puzzle together until I was here, in the dungeon. Now you know everything.
Did Saskia know the Lodge's plans?
She didn't even know the Lodge existed. Philippa told her that the sorceresses would support an independent state in the Pontar Valley, no strings attached. A fairy tale, but Saskia bought it. Saskia backed Philippa, and the people backed Saskia.
Who had Foltest assassinated?
I have no idea. Perhaps after Demavend's successful assassination, Sheila and Philippa decided to take the next step.
That would be stupid. Killing Demavend was a way to take control of the Pontar Valley. People would forget the regicide in a year, and the Lodge could put its plan in motion. They had to know that if Foltest died, men like Roach wouldn't rest until they learned why that had happened.
One thing is certain. Letho killed Foltest, and Sheila was working with Letho.
Ever find out what Sheila was actually doing in Flotsam? I find it hard to believe she went there just to kill a monster and earn a few orans.
You're right, of course. It had something to do with Letho and the Scoia'tael.
What did she want from Yorveth?
The Scoia'tael were Saskia's trump card. I expect Sheila needed to know what the elves would do, given that a war with Henselt was practically inevitable.
That'll have to do for now.
We'll learn more at the talks.
You're going to attend?
You have no memory of how the world worked before the Thanet massacre.
Actually, I know exactly how it worked.
That means...
We'll talk about my memory later.
All right. If the Council and Conclave still existed, kings wouldn't be assassinated and massacres would be less frequent. This is our chance to restore these institutions, and we shouldn't miss it. Normalizing relations between the rulers and the mages who advise them is our only chance for peace.
And our only chance to dismantle the Lodge.
The Lodge will disintegrate anyway. Once the kings learn it was behind the assassinations, they'll start a witch hunt. We can prevent that from happening. I'm all for punishing the guilty, but can't abide collective responsibility. I'm ready to go and reveal everything I know about Philippa Isleheart, Sheila de Tancerville, and their schemes.
Let's go then.
We shouldn't arrive at the same time. Let's split up.
The Lodge remembers too.
Rest assured, I won't let anyone compress me again.
Some of the sorceresses will be surprised to see you. Watch them closely.
Don't worry, I'll manage. See you at the talks.
All right.
Be gone! You've no business here!
Does the name Brigida Papabroc ring any bells?
Rings bells, sets off whistles, why? I believe my loins have grown warm. Touch my plums, touch my plums!
Excuse me.
Fruit, Witcher! Especially fruit of the south. Tender, juicy, soft on the exterior. That's what I think of when you mention Dame Brigida. The woman is positively obsessed.
I was hoping for a straighter answer.
A man of your experience surely understands what I mean.
So you admit you know her well?
I know her, I have known her, and I expect I yet will, and I'm not alone in that. Though, mind you, I admire the woman. Her kind of ambition is rare among both genders.
Ever taken advantage of that? Ever asked her to run errands for you?
One must be careful with the ambitious. They are almost always running their own errands. Asking them to do yours simply invites them to use you. Baron Kimbolt learned that the hard way. But why ask me about the lass, here and now of all times and places? Surely, given your close allegiance and, no doubt, many a shared drinking binge, Commander Roach has told you all.
Brigida used Baron Kimbolt?
Continues to, I surmise.
To what end?
You cannot expect me to answer every little query that pops into your mind, Witcher.
Commander Roach can be strangely discreet. What do you know?
I'm hardly one to tell another man's secrets.
Indulge me.
If you must know, the rascal Roach rogered our dear Brigida just before he passed her off onto me, among others, with a purpose in mind, I suspect.
He'll be interested to hear what you had to say.
My, my, aren't we dutiful?
I believe there's been a misunderstanding, my lord.
Get out, before I call my guards.
And what might I convey?
Nothing.
Baron, sir, you gave your word.
For the last time, out! Tend to this matter.
Who was that thug I passed in the doorway?
He's of no concern to you.
People like him sometimes do stupid things.
Did I ask for your opinion on the matter?
The convoy carrying Anais and Busi was ambushed. Why?
I'd like to know that myself.
I've seen your letter to Horst Lubbock, the one in which you ordered him to abandon the planned route.
Nonsense! I sent no such letter.
The letter bears your seal and signature, Baron.
Where is it?
That's immaterial just now.
If that's the situation, I've said all I have to say. I wrote no such letter.
Words come cheap, Baron. I'm finding it hard to believe you.
I care little for what you believe. If this letter exists, we are dealing with a forgery. Whoever is behind this has crossed a Temerian noble and will be duly punished. A scribe will test the letter and confirm what I claim.
My claim? My scribe? I'd hardly call that impartial. Maybe I should just deliver the letter to Natalis.
Any accusation will be quickly dismissed. Heed my words, Witcher. It would be unwise of you to jump to any conclusions. Speak with my scribe. There are objective means of examining the letter's authenticity. I promise to pay you well for learning the truth.
The truth does taste better when payment's involved.
The King of Reagents?
Drunker than a bard. Won't get anything out of him. Maybe there's something about testing letters in his notes.
Water quenches lime like beer quenches thirst.
I don't know any of these substances. Best not risk destroying the letter. Maybe there's a form...
Light, quench, shit, rinse. Young alchemist, do as you order. I dash it to water. The king of reagents.
You will the facts evince. To read the truth by lies deformed, guano into piss transform. I need to make the substance that will bring out the dye and apply it to the letter. How did it go? How did it go?